this module, I'll demonstrate how to use a task manager to troubleshoot problems in Windows 11. Task manager used to be part of the taskbar in the past. So you'd typically right-click on the taskbar and then it would be an option for task manager. However, that's no longer available there. You can access a task manager by either simply searching for it under the start menu or Windows search. There are a couple other ways to get to the task manager. If you right-click on the start menu, there is also the option to click on task manager from here. And then it's going to take us typically to something like this. For the first time, unless you change it, it's going to be something like this. So this is going to list the applications that are running. However, if you want to see additional details as far as what's running in the system, what processing is taking place and so on, then you can click here on more details and you'll be able to see the processes that are currently running in the PC. A lot of times if the PC is really running, the fans are running really loud and so on, then there is typically an issue with the PC or one of the applications in the computer and you want to kind of stop that application. Identify it and stop it. Now to identify what application is causing the issue, notice in my case here, the CPU utilization is 26%, around 26 to 27%. So something is using it because typically it should be about 4 to 7%. Now, as we scroll up here, you can identify the program that is causing the high utilization by clicking here on the CPU utilization. And we want to sort it by highest to lowest. So in my case, notice that the Camtasia recorder is the one that is taking most of the processing power. Obviously, that's because I'm doing this video tutorial at this point. But if it was something else that I don't need it to be running right now, or it was unnecessary, then I could simply click on it and then click on End Task. And so basically, let's assume this is the process that's taking most of the CPU. You simply click on it, and then you choose End Task, and it's going to close that process. In some cases, it may not be just a CPU that is slowing down your system. In some cases, it may be certain apps that are taking most of the memory. So you can go here and do the same thing with the memory to identify what's taking most of the memory in your computer. Other times it may be that the disk utilization, it's struggling, and that's how you can identify that you have a problem with the speed of your disk. Here you can also identify how the processor or different components are doing over a period of time. So if we click here on the CPU, you'd be able to identify the usage under the memory usage, the solid state drives or the drives, Wi-Fi and graphics card and so on. Now, one of the things under the performance tab that comes in very handy is also this resource monitor. This is going in depth and looking at as to what's happening behind the scenes, whether it's the processor usage, what process, how much, what actual thread is utilizing a certain service, and which potential service is causing the issues in the system. So notice you can do it disk-based. So let's say here, notice that my antivirus software is using quite a bit of the read-write data at this point in the PC. And the way you find out what each one of these is, you can either Google search them or there is a way that you can also find the file location in your PC, but probably searching through Google is probably the best option. Now, once you're in Resource Monitor, notice that there are also, that was the overview, but you can go at various levels, like at the CPU level, memory level, disk level, or network level as well. Now, there is also the app history here that you can kind of check and see what's causing the usage. This is very similar to an iPhone app history. Under the startup, this is really helpful as well because this is where you can turn off certain features. So let's say you're not using OneDrive in your computer and you want to disable the applications on startup. So here I can just simply go to OneDrive and choose to disable this so it doesn't start up when the computer starts up at the beginning of each day or whenever you reboot it. Additionally, there are other details here and other services that are configured and running and so on, and those are a little bit more advanced. So you don't want to typically turn off something from here unless you know what you're doing. Another way to get to the task manager is by pressing Ctrl-Alt-Delete, and then you choose Task Manager, and that'll take you to the same location as well.